In this video, I'll be making an ingot mold from a scrap stainless steel square tube. The dimensions for the tube are 2 inches by 2 inches with a 1/4 inch thick wall. I'll cut off the end of the tube to have a straight, clean cut to start with. Now that we have a straight end, I'll mark the tube with the cuts I'll be making. These measurements can be as you desire, but I'm wanting a 6-inch mold. I also want to have the ends of the mold higher than the walls to aid in removing the ingots. I'm marking the tube at 2 1/4, 8 1/4, and 10.5 inches. For the end cuts, I'll be cutting until I reach the bottom wall. I will now cut the end pieces from the bottom wall to meet with the other cut. This will leave a tongue that we will be folding up to seal the ends of the mold. I will remove some material from the folding points to aid it when folding. That was not part of the plan. Well, I underestimated the strength of the steel. Since folding was not possible, I will resort to cutting off the ends. The next cut will be to create the opening for the pour and release of the ingot. I used a piece of 2x4 to assist with holding the steel in place. All of the cuts are now complete. Now it's time to weld the pieces together. I'm removing the excess from the weld to help me spot any places I've missed when I check for leaks. For the leak test, place a paper towel underneath your mold and fill your mold with water. It looks like mine has a few leaks and will have to go back to the welding station. I still had a minor leak on the second test. After scratching my head and thinking for a few seconds, I decided to give a second pass of weld to the entire piece. Third time was the charm. No leaks were coming from the bottom edges, side edges, or the corners. A successful leak test. Thank you guys for watching the video. Please comment, like, and subscribe if you found some of this information useful. We will see you on the next video where we actually make ingots with this mold.